already, so this is the snow, or the aftermath of the snow we got here in Hutchinson, Kansas. Today is December 22nd, it is Thursday, and there's a bunch of police up ahead, but anyways, it's a negative 4 degrees outside right now, with a like negative 30 some degree wind chill, so it's really cold outside, and it's windy, which just makes the cold air even worse. But I'm out for a drive in the snow. I'm on 30th Avenue, heading east. Something happened up here, and I think it's a wreck. Oh yeah, it's definitely a wreck. I was going to stop up here by Dylan's, but I think I'm just going to spin around and kind of go up towards 17th, see what it looks like around town. I got an idea what it looks like on Main Street already. I mean downtown Main Street, because I've seen it this morning on the Hutchinson live cam, the Estes Park Hutch live cam. I've seen it on there. By the way, defrosting the ice off my windshield and scraping it off was an utter nightmare. Just because of the negative 30-some degree windshield constantly blowing up against my windshield as it was trying to defrost. Dylan's. Got to Dylan's fuel station. Oh shoot, I think it's blocked off from here. It is. Look how the snow is blown up against those bushes. That's crazy. Well, this is going to make for a white Christmas, because this snow is not going to melt before Christmas Day. Just because tomorrow the high is only like 12 or 14 degrees, and Saturday, Christmas Eve, the highs were like 20 some degrees, and same thing with Christmas Day, the highs were like in the 20s. I'm gonna flip back around, take Lorraine down to 17th, and then go over to where the Hutch Mall is at and stuff. Here's that wind kicking up. You can see it's blowing up the snow off the street. That's a lot of heavy wind. Now you can see just how cold it is out here. Here's that here's an accident scene. Looks like they're just now sending out cones and stuff. Well, they got one vehicle. Nope, they didn't get the one vehicle towed. It's right here. It kind of looks like the guy, that tan truck, it looks like he pulled out of the Dillon's parking lot in front of the other truck. And people do stupid stuff like that during this type of weather, because they don't think that you can't stop on a dime like you can on normal roads in normal weather conditions. On roads like this, that are covered in snow, and there's ice under some of the snow, there's no way someone can slow down in enough time if you pull out in front of them. When I drive out in weather like this, I drive very carefully and take my time. And I'm never worried about accidentally wrecking into someone. I'm always worried about some idiot like wrecking into me that's not paying attention, going way too fast, or I'm worried about someone pulling out in front of me on an icy road, and I have nothing to, and I could do nothing but slam into them. This is definitely one of the coldest days we've ever had in December in a long, long, very long time. In fact, they're saying this was like historic, but I feel like we've had really cold winters before, and I know we have, but not this cold, where it's a -4 during the daytime and only 1 degree for the absolute high. And I'm not even sure if it's even going to reach 1 degree today, with just how cold it is. It might get the sun out. But temperatures like this in Kansas is not unusual. Like, where the daytime temperatures only a high of like negative some degrees or whatever, this is pretty normal for Kansas. Not during December though. Usually we have our much colder days during January through March. That's the time frame we normally see these major cold spells, I should say. There's the alley, it looks closed. Now we're coming up on 17th Avenue, and I'm going to make a left turn here to go towards the mall. I'm basically just doing kind of a joyride to see what things look like around town. I didn't leave my house at all today until recently. I've been home most of the day, and I think it's like 1 past 1 o'clock right now. But this morning, I didn't go anywhere. I was supposed to work today, but yesterday I had requested that I could take today off, and they allowed me to take today off because of the weather that was coming. I just didn't want to drive to work, and I work out of town, so I didn't want to drive out of town on the highway to work and having to deal with the snowstorm that was here this morning and getting a potential wrecking out. And I wasn't sure how bad the weather would be throughout the entire day. So I thought it was more safe to take the day off versus working and going there and risking my life. So I wasn't going to do that. I just decided to stay home. Glad I did, because when I looked out the window this morning, because I woke up around 7, usually I leave my house about 6 something. When I looked out my window this morning, it was snowing really heavy and the wind was insane. So 17th Avenue. And for those who have not seen 17th Avenue in Hutchinson in a long time, a lot has changed. I mean, quite a bit. So if you haven't been in Hutchinson in the last, I would say, 10 plus years, yeah, quite a bit has changed down here. Cordoba is where the Bueno used to be. And this car wash is where Shoreline Stockade used to be. On this side, actually here first, that's where the City Buffet was. Over here, Dunkin' Donuts is new. Aspen Dino's new, in front of the old Target. Target's not here anymore. I believe Target left in 2016. 2015, something like that. Of course, we got all of these places now on this side. The Olive Garden. Olive Garden came back in 2012, I think. We got Buffalo Wild Wings. Got Mattress Firm and all those stores and a rib crib. And there's the rib crib. The AT&T store. On this side, we now got Chick-fil-A. Got the Pizza Ranch where the Red Lobster used to be. Chili's is still there. It's right down there. It's now the Express Wellness Clinic right here as well. And you see there's a Chick-fil-A. And it's also a Verizon. And for those who have not been in Hutchinson for a long, long time, there's a Lowe's over here. I believe the Lowe's was built back in 2007 or 2006. I'm not entirely sure. I didn't move to Hutchinson until 2011. I just know at some point, because I used to work at that Lowe's, I just know at some point they built that Lowe's down here, and it had to be 2005 to 2007 range. IHOP, of course, is still here. There's a fuel station in front of Walmart. This is the Chick-fil-A. There's the Express Wellness Clinic. Pizza Ranch. Of course, the IHOP. And we got the Chili's, which for some reason someone looks like they're selling the property. So here's the Hutchinson Mall. I've done a tour of the Hutchinson Mall in one of my most recent video of the DP Squids. Someone's watching me mall video. I've done an outside tour of it and a small Porsche inside tour. That bold thing across the street, of course, was Target. Now it's some kind of a manufacturing plant or warehouse distribution center, I should say. And this is where Dillard's used to be. You now got Harbor Freight, TJ Maxx, Ulta, and got a Dollar Tree. And of course, you got Goodies up here, what used to be Goodies, which I heard moved to the Hutchinson Mall back in 2005, I think? 2004? That was Goodies, not anymore. And this person's driving like dangerously slow. Ain't got an Ollie's that has taken a part of the old JCPenney the Ollie's is on the side where the JCPenney salon used to be, and the shoe department was back there. And right here at this front section is now a what's called a Hutch Vintage Market. It's basically like an antique mall. Oh, what is this called? It's more than an antique mall. It's a place. It's one of those places where you can get a booth. You can rent a booth out and sell stuff yourself. So it's basically what it is. So the vendors in here are the booths in here are all local people only. And I like how they put that big dude at the top of this thing. This looks funny. It's kind of cool. So, let me get a front shot here. That's what this place is now. It's called Hutch Vintage Market. Antiques, vintage, and home decor. And they did that. They put one of those old school cars up there. It's part of their company theme, if you will. Down here, got 11th Avenue, a McDonald's, Texas T-Bone, is where the, what's that called, it used to be a different, Lone Star Steakhouse used to be there, now it's a Texas T-Bone Steakhouse, Arby's, you got a Subway, which a lot of this stuff was here, has been here for many years, besides the Texas T-Bone that moved in. Now you got the Kansas Department of Children and Family, whatever you want to call it. It's right here in this field, across from where Sears used to be. They built that here in 2020. Dunham Sports now occupies the former Sears space. And of course, everyone knows, you got Home Depot down here in Walmart on this side, which this stuff has always been here. I shouldn't say always, but it's been here for a very long time. I know the Walmart at one point, and this is many moons ago, way back in the 80s when the mall was first built, Walmart used to be right here in this whole section of the Hobby Lobby and Orchlands. There we go. Coming back up on around where IHOP and Chili's and all that's at. Did a full circle. There's Pizza Ranch again. Probably can see things clearer now from this way. Got the Express Wellness Center, which was built in 2020. Chick-fil-A. They put that there in 2018, 2019, I think. And that Verizon, I believe they built that Verizon there in 2014, 2015 range. And that's the Verizon that used to be on 11th Avenue in that little strip mall across or near near the Arby's. Of course, back there, you got the Lowe's behind the Petco. Switch hands for recording. My hands are arm is getting tired. Now I can see this side clearer coming back this way. So on this side, we got the Applebee's, which has always been there. And over here, got Aspen Dino, which I don't know if it's officially open yet or not. And Dunkin' Donuts, which just opened very recently, like last month. And this side, what used to be a city buffet, and someone said like an all-American buffet before, but now it's that, Panda Express, or whatever it's called, yeah, Panda Express and all that. Motel 8. Starbucks and all that. And on that side, you got some stuff on there as well. I know there used to be a Hollywood Video on the strip mall where the Starbucks is at. I believe there was just a Starbucks there at the time, and the whole other portion of it was the Hollywood Video. And I know this because I looked at Google Maps, and I went back in time on Street View, and I saw Hollywood Video was there back in like 2007. And over there, for those who have not been in Hutchinson for a very long time, is a Kohl's now. And prior to, that was just a field, as you probably remembered. And over here, we got the Metropolitan Coffee Shop and other various businesses like a nail salon, a laundromat, and some other stuff. Here's that Kohl's. Back in, at that traffic light I was just at right there, back in 2015, I believe it was, around December or November of 2015, we had an ice storm, and I was coming back from Starbucks with my sister. We had gotten drinks, and we weren't going to leave the house that day. Work was canceled. We were actually going to stay home, but we had Starbucks gift cards that we wanted to use. So we decided to drive over to Starbucks. I don't remember where we got the gift cards from, because it wasn't Christmas yet. But we had Starbucks gift cards. So we drove down to Starbucks just to get a drink, and when we're coming back on 17th, I got up to the light, and just keep in mind, this is when the ice storm was here, and the roads were covered in just a solid layer of black ice. And there was snow outside as well. When I was driving, coming up to that light, basically, and there was a guy sitting there at the light, already stopped, and I was going maybe 20 miles an hour. I was going very, very slow, and this was back when I had my little Saturn Ion, and I put on my brakes very slowly, because I was on ice, and the moment I touched those brakes, my car started to slide out, and I lost control, I was going very slow, thankfully. So what I did, I just turned the wheel as sharp as I could to the right, and it caused my car to spin outside, like spin outside. And it prevented me from sliding into the back of the truck that was in front of me. So as my car came to a rest, I looked down to put it into reverse, you know, to straighten my vehicle out at the light. And right as I put it in reverse, I looked to my side, and my sister panicked. I heard her say something. I looked over, and I seen a, like, small Chevrolet S10 truck. It was blue in color, with a lady texting and driving. She was on her phone. Her phone was on a steering wheel like this. And she was texting, looking down at her phone, going full speed down that road. And I embraced her impact, because I knew exactly what was going to happen. And sure enough, she looked up at the last second, and she tried to slam on her brakes, and it was already too late. And she slams into the side of my car. My sister and I's coffee splashes everywhere. I mean, the lids pop off our cups, the coffee goes all over my car. And she slammed into my car so hard, it blew out the entire back door panel and the whole back end where the trunk is at. She blew all that up to shreds and had my car slide on the ice. So, I still remember that day really well, but it was a bittersweet end, because at the end of it, her insurance company had to pay me. Her insurance company had to pay me for my vehicle being basically totaled. And that's what happened. Cops got out of the car for some reason. Something's going on over here. Cop pulled up here and one pulled inside. I'm not sure what they're doing. Looks like they may be getting ready to direct traffic or something. I'm not sure. Oh no, they're all meeting together right there. So here's downtown Hutchinson, which anyone that's watched my channel long enough has seen quite a bit of. Now we'll say this though. The snow we had gotten from the snowstorm isn't much at all. Like, this is hardly any snow. The main part of the storm, that's the worst part of it, is the dangerously cold air. Like I said, if you stand outside, if you were to stand outside within 5 minutes, any exposed skin, you could get frostbite. So keep seeing apartments going for rent right here. This huge building is the Plaza Tower. The Plaza Towers. Those are all apartments up there. Way back in its day when the building was built, it was actually a hotel. It was called the Baker Hotel. But of course now it's really nice apartments. The apartments up there are quite huge, because the old hotel rooms that were up there were enormous. It was a luxury hotel back in its day. So, they have quite a few nice apartments up there. I thought about renting up there before several times, just because of the view you would get. And it's all bills paid, so the only thing you would pay for is rent, and that's it. And all your, like, electric and everything else, it's already paid for by the landlord. And rent's not too expensive there. Back in the day, rent was pretty reasonable. When I first looked at them, rent was $400 a month for a one-bedroom apartment. Now, keep in mind, the one-bedroom apartment was not an average-sized one-bedroom apartment. It was huge. Like, your bedroom, I don't know the square footage, but it's enormous. The bedroom itself is almost like a huge living room. You got a separate bedroom, you got a huge living room, a dining room, a pretty decent sized kitchen with your bathroom. So, pretty large apartments in a pretty secure building, which means only you need a special key card to get in, because only tenants can get into there. So for $400 back then, that was a really good deal. Today, they go for $575, which is the highest they've ever been. Oh, look at that big Santa on the Swiss market. Let's try and get a view of it. Turn around over here. Westlake Ace Hardware took the sign down. I'm wondering if they're putting up a new sign soon. They probably are. I don't think they're closing or closed. I don't see that being possible, because those Ace Hardware stores around here stay pretty busy. But I noticed the sign is missing. The letters of the sign anyways, they're black letters. It says Ace. Westlake Ace Hardware. And I could definitely tell they're open, because you got all their stuff up front yet. And the lights are on and everything. But the sign is missing.